if you're setting up a pretty big home lab, maybe even some people would call this a mini data center or a home data center, then there are special electrical requirements that you need to take into consideration. This does not run off your typical 110 voltage AC. This is running off a substantially higher voltage system. Today, I'm going to show you some of the inner workings of what that's like, what the wiring was like, and how this is powering all of this. We're also going to check out what the electrical consumption is on this in real time. I hope you're excited. Let's get started. So any project like this is incredibly dangerous and not something you should attempt. You definitely need to call an electrician for this. And also you probably need to get some permits that can be handled by your electrician. Make sure you do that step here. Let me talk about what I did though for this setup. So we have our service coming into the house here. This is an aerial drop service. And we have a 125 amp breaker that I've installed that is connecting this here, is connecting up here to the main run and pulled all the way through, all the way like 85 feet of it through the attic with incredibly rigid, hard to manage wire. And we're not talking any wire, we're talking service cable. And service cable is very difficult to work with if you are a single person, especially if you are in a low pitch roof situation. This is yet another reason that it pays a lot of dividends to have somebody else do this kind of work, because one screw up and you could fall through your attic. And as well, when you're dealing with service wire, there's some things that you probably need to know. Going from copper to aluminum is not something you should do. They separated disconnect on it. On one side, having aluminum and having that go to a sub panel is okay, because the lugs on this are actually all aluminum. And coming in here, we have our copper connection that is spanned over here to the 125 amps. And so we had this sized for 125 amps because on the other side of this, originally we had two 10 kilowatt, 11 kVA Eaton 9PX 11K units. Those are amazing units. One of them is now out of commission. So I'm actually doing some rearranging. So this seemed like a good time to talk about this. Let's go inside and check out what's going on the racks and the sub panel. And so this is the sub panel that we have for the garage data center. And this is supplied by that 1-aught cabling that you saw, the service wire. And this is just, you know, 250 amps for the breakers that go to the whips. And that is two whips that we have ran over into there. That's in liquid type. And if you're running wire and it is stranded, you definitely want to use some liquid tight to ensure that it's going to be safe as you run it over there. And you might need to make sure that you also have good grounds run over there at the same time, because grounding your rack is a very important thing to do. And this is a fully grounded bond system. Now, I am going to wire up a different UPS to that. And that's why you should hit subscribe and like on this channel and ring that bell so that you get notified when we set that next UPS up. But currently this 50 amp breaker is what's supplying the rack over here. And this is actually an undersized breaker, just a little bit for the protection load over there. But I know that going into it, and I make sure that the UPS itself is not going to be pulling hard on it because I don't have that much load on that UPS. Let's take a look at the UPS itself now. And so this is the Eaton 9PX 11K unit that we have. And this is a really nice unit for sure. I miss the fact that the other one is gone. But like I mentioned, we've got another UPS over there, so we'll be getting that in here soon. But this unit here is currently running right around, oh, I guess that's 2.4. I'm not sure if you can see that. Let's see if we can zoom in a little bit. So you can see that we're running in high efficiency mode, and we're also pulling about 2.2 to 2.4 kilowatts of power on this with one EBM with about 26 minutes of runtime at a 95% efficiency. Now, that is not running in double conversion currently, but I will have that running in double conversion every time there's a storm coming in, just to make sure that any potential problems we have could be mitigated. Now, that is supplying enough power for me to be able to run everything in these racks. You see, I've got these four R930s here. These are quad sockets, and actually I'm in the process of rebalancing them. I did have four R920s over here. Those were 1.1 kilowatts each to run. So I'm going to be moving two of these over to here and re-racking those shortly, and that'll allow me to distribute the load very evenly that's actually being drawn on each one of the legs of the PDU units on the back. And those are the power distribution units. So this is the UPS, and we're gonna next check out the back of the unit and the PDUs. You can see here, we're gonna have two of these R930s running on this system. We've got our KVM, we have an R520, which is probably not gonna be running for super long, and we've got our networking gear, which actually consumes a pretty surprising amount of electricity. Then on this one over here, we'll have the tape library, which runs pretty intermittently. Then we'll have two additional R930s. All the R930s don't stay powered on. Those are only for special use. I only power them up when they're needed. We have the T620 and the R720XD. Both of those are probably things that get replaced pretty shortly. And then over here, we've got about 2.6 petabytes worth of total space that is raw on this system. We've got three JBODs with disks. Two of them are powered up right now. The TrueNAS system that I run is powered off the R720XD, and it connects to the fourth JBOD down there. As well, down here, we've got our first Epic server, and that is the 7B12 version, which is a 64-core, 128-thread monster. Let's go check out the back of this rack. If you look up here, you can see the ingress point for the whips, and this whip is the whip that we still have that is actually running and powered right now. This is the liquid type that I was talking about. We also have the second whip that's up there. It's coiled up right now and it's out of reach, out of use. So we also have this running down to the backside of the UPS. So the UPS has an inlet and it also has a mini PDU of its own here. It only has three distribution slots, but this is especially built for this unit and it is able to communicate with the unit because it has a serial connection on it. So each one of these powers one of these larger distribution units. So each one of these is the CDU units that we have. These are really nice units. They're switched and metered, so I can actually gather statistics on the electric usage of them as they're running. If you note here, like I said, I don't even leave the R930s plugged in because even plugged in and turned off, completely turned off, they still eat 100 watts of power each per hour. So that's 400 watts of power that would be eaten by that if those were plugged in. But I do keep them tied up here so that I can get them plugged over if I need to run a workload pretty efficiently. And you can see the back of this unit has a display that's showing what kind of amperage is being used. So this is 2.2 amps on the bank that is the top bank. So this is the networking bank up here. And if you look at that, that is 2.2, and my voltage runs right around 245 volts. So 2.2 times 245 is the total amount of watts that's being squeezed out of this particular bank. That's a lot of wattage, right? So this is only one server running that is consuming 3 amps of electricity at a time. That's the T620. But the T620 is definitely got every single slot full. It's RAM's maxed out and it's got 2667 V2s. It's doing heavy processing all the time. And then if we move on over here, we can see that we've got two units connected up here. This is about 5.3 amps that we're pulling on these top two units. And then down here, we've got 1.3. And the nice thing about using a 220 system with a desktop computer is the switching power supplies in modern computers are able to accept either. So we can actually use our desktop power supply here for this in this case, which is a defined Meshify XL2. Not super ideal, but looking for what kind of cases can fit in a rack to optimize the size that you're using, like a 4U, a 5U would be ideal. But right now I've just got it in this case and it does get the job done. So you can see that I've also tied up all of these 30 amp cables. These are 30 amp PDUs. And so I've got these all tied up so they're up off the ground. That helps a little bit with bugs trying to get up here. As you can see, probably with the camera and the resolution of it, we do get some bugs up here. For sure we get some bugs up here. But each one of these also has an independent breaker on it. So each one of these circuit breakers can be independently turned on and off, as well as the entire unit can go into bypass mode with this handle right here. So I hope you've enjoyed this overview of the rack electrical that I'm running. Again, keep in mind, this is something you should definitely consider hiring a professional for. This is a pretty advanced DIY project that you should not try for yourself the first time. It can and very likely could result in injury to you. And it could be as simple as falling through the roof, but coming through your attic is pretty bad. And like, especially if you've got a low pitched attic, it's horrible. This roof is a very low pitch. That made running this absolutely a nightmare because you saw how rigid that wire was. So definitely call a professional, get a quote from an electrician, and also make sure that you're adhering to all the permits in your city or municipality. Those are going to vary from every city to city and county to county, and possibly even state to state. So I hope you had a good time checking this out. And like I said, be safe. Don't run out and try to do this yourself. Everybody have a great rest of your day, and I will check you guys out next time.